How to do a sealed system repair using Vulkan Lokring couplers. For the required tools, please consult your local LG representative. Always wear gloves and put on safety goggles. R600A is highly flammable. Evacuation of old refrigerant. Open a window. Prepare the pinch pliers. Mount one side of the quick coupler to the pierce part, the other on the manometer hose. Set the pliers to the correct pipe diameter and lock the position with the nut. Make sure that you have enough space to connect the charging hose. Check the refrigeration circuit. Connect the circuit with a measuring manifold. Power on the refrigerator. Use a personal protection adapter for safety. Check the low side pressure to confirm your diagnosis. Unplug the power. Connect a quick release coupler to the evacuation hose. Put the hose outside. You can see the refrigerant flow. Stop evacuating when no more refrigerant is observed. Replace the compressor and dryer. Clean all tubes radial to avoid grooves. Use abrasive fleece or sandpaper grit 120. Cut the compressor pipes close to the compressor connections. Use an adjustable mini tube cutter for a clean cut without squeezing the pipe. In tight assembly areas, use tube cutting pliers instead. Remove the dryer holder to create space for removing the compressor. Remove the ground wire and all four mounting brackets. Remove the PTC cover and the connector. Be careful when removing the compressor. Keep it horizontal to prevent oil spill. Use a capillary tube cutter and cut the pipe in a 45 degree angle. If needed, gently bend the pipes. Deburr the sharp edges. Measure the pipe dimensions to select the correct Vulkan connectors. Reuse the damper from the old compressor. Make sure the compressor is positioned well on the rubber dampers. Apply all the mounting brackets. Leave the rubber caps on as long as possible to prevent air and moisture from entering. Position the pipes straight towards each other. You need roughly 2 cm on each end to be able to fully insert the Vulkan connector. Remove the compressor caps. Apply lock prep and make sure to stay around 1 cm from the pipe end to avoid that it gets in the pipe. Insert the lock ring as far as it will go. Rotate the connector 360 degrees to evenly distribute the lock prep. After adding the lock prep, assemble within 1 minute. Make sure that the hand tool jaws completely cover the connector. Stabilize one side of the tool with your body. Press with the other hand. Make sure the lock ring is securely tightened. Follow the same steps. Do not apply lock prep at the pipe end. Insert and rotate the connector and assemble within 1 minute. Bend the charging tube at this point. When connected to the compressor, this is not possible anymore without the risk of leaks. Apply the charging tube, clean it, apply lock prep, bring the tube into an accessible position and press the lock rings together. Mount the ground wire, the compressor connector, and the compressor cover. Always make sure the drier packing is sealed. If already open, do not use. Check the direction arrow on the drier. The arrow points to the capillary tube connection. The drier pipe should measure 4 mm. In case a type with thicker end is supplied, cut it on both sides. Clean the tube and if needed, gently straighten the pipe. Insert the capillary tube connector over the pipe so it sticks out between 1 and 2 cm. Bend the capi so the connector cannot move any further. If needed, cut the pipe ends and deburr the sharp edges. Ensure the correct direction of the drier. First, connect the hotline side of the drier. Before connecting the capillary side, first test if the drier is not blocked. After plugging in the power, wait until the compressor starts. Unplug the power. Bring the connector towards the pipe end to apply a lock prep on the correct location. Push the connector towards the bended side and rotate to distribute the lock prep. Insert the capillary pipe end through the drier and make sure no lock prep enters the capillary tube. Push the connector and capillary pipe so the drier pipe end pushes to the middle of the connector. Rotate the connector to distribute the lock prep on the drier side too. Observe the lock prep curing time before gently bending the pipes. Inject nitrogen for leak checks. Execute a pressure test with nitrogen. Start with closed valves. Open the main valve. Adjust the pressure to around 8 or 9 bar. Turn the highlighted side of the quick coupler on the charging tube. and the other end on the hose. Connect the hose to the charging tube. Gently open the valve to the refrigerator hose. Check for system leaks. Use enough spray to make sure you notice even the smallest leak. At the end of the test, close the nitrogen valves and disconnect the quick coupler. Vacuuming. Set up the vacuuming station and the refrigerant charging station. Before connecting the hoses to the refrigerator, make sure all manometer valves are closed. Depending on the position of the drier Schrader valve, it may help to use a 90 degree angle quick coupler for Schrader valves. Before starting to vacuum, open the low side and release the hose valve to make sure there is no pressure in the system. Then close both valves again. Plug in the power and start the pump. Open the valves as follows. First, the vacuum pump valve. Second, slowly open the vacuum meter valve and adjust the reference meter. Third, the low and high pressure valves. And finally, the ball valve. Vacuum for 30 minutes to ensure a deep vacuum and to remove the water vapor from the system. After 30 minutes, first close the ball valve, then close the vacuum hose valve, then turn off the vacuum pump. Wait at least 10 minutes to check that the pressure does not increase. Then close all the remaining valves. Filling with refrigerant. See the cabinet label in the fridge part for the filling weight, 53 grams in this example. Turn on the scale. Try to avoid touching the scale, hose and refrigerant bottle. The value must be zero at this point. Reset if needed. Open the extraction valve. Wait until a constant value is displayed. Open the ball valve. Close the ball valve 15 grams before the filling weight is achieved, 38 grams in this example. Top up the required filling weight by slightly opening the ball valve. Close the cartridge valve and turn off the scale. open the bowl valve and allow gas to flow from the charging hose into the refrigeration circuit. Turn on the compressor. Check the suction and condensing pressures. The high side pressure will go to roughly 3 bar and the low side pressure to roughly 0.4. The measured values highly depend on the ambient temperature. Disconnect the hose from the dryer. Open the pressure and suction valves. The pressure briefly rises and then drops to stable values. The system extracts refrigerant from the hoses. Wait a few minutes and watch the low pressure stabilize. When the pressure on the suction manometer no longer drops, disconnect the hose from the charging tube. Turn off the compressor. Secure the screw caps using lock prep. Use a Metra tester or equivalent to perform safety and functional tests.